Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Most of the standard SpaceX updates today will consist of information about upcoming launches, with two Falcon 9 launches expected to take place in a matter of days. Then over to Boca Chica to check out some infrastructure updates as well as the recent and upcoming SN6 testing. So let's head straight in and get up to date. To begin with, I want to show you a tweet from somebody called Jonathan McDowell about a retired Starlink satellite. He said, Starlink 58 re-entered between 6 a.m. and 7:20 a.m. UTC August 23rd. It is the seventh satellite from the May 2019 prototype launch batch to re-enter. Then, as I said, we have a couple of Falcon 9 launches over the space of less than 24 hours. Originally scheduled for Thursday 27th, you can see on the SpaceXFans website the launch of Sayacom 1B is now expected to lift off on Friday 28th at 11:19 p.m. UTC or 7:19 p.m. EDT. Also, we now know which booster will launch this mission, and turns out it's B1059. This booster previously launched 3 missions and so will be launching on its 4th mission on Friday. So even though SpaceX are planning to launch Sayacom 1B on Friday, they've also got another launch on Saturday 29th at 2:30 p.m. UTC or 10:30 a.m. EDT. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website again, they're probably going to be launching Starlink 11 within a matter of hours after Sayacom 1B. Exciting launch schedule coming up for the remaining week of this month. Although, moving on to the Boca Chica news, there has recently been a big divide between people as to whether or not the Super Heavy launch pad construction is actually a water tower. I've always thought it's a launch mount since the sign on the fence says so, and turns out it categorically is a mount according to Elon Musk. Nearby at Pad B, engineers are continuing to work on preparing the new launch mount for action. Turns out they've even begun installing some mass simulators, which could indicate that a Starship may very soon be sitting on it. Elsewhere around the facility, there was an interesting new arrival spotted on the back of a trailer. Over by where the Starship tanks are produced, the new giant high bay is still progressing. Here is the latest view of how the building is coming along, and I believe it may just need one more half level and a roof before it reaches the full 81 meters in height. Further to this, engineers have already begun the process of constructing the second half of the fourth level, as you can see this high bay section lifted. As of now, they've already put together two corners of this new level and looks like what could be the beginning of the roof. Can't wait until it's complete, then we could start seeing super heavy sections emerge from tents and begin stacking. That will be awesome. However, before we look at Starship serial number updates, there's always bits of Starships moving around the yard. Here you can see another new stainless steel ring being prepared to be moved. The nosecone section we saw last episode has some interesting metal additions added to it. Not sure what they are doing, but could we see a different nosecone build in the works? Could just be that these additional pieces of metal help with joining the tapered sections. Next, there is an interesting move that has been spotted in a construction yard. Here you can see we have SM5, which was recently moved from the test area to the production area and into the mid bay alongside SN8. Now though, it's been moved back out, so the question is, what's next on the agenda for this vehicle? I'm thinking maybe the move could be to do with freeing up some space so another Starship tank can progress. SpaceX are preparing SM5 now for its next hop after a beautiful 150 meter hop just a few weeks ago. One of the parts of the process right now is to swap out a COPV tank. Its successor, on the other hand, was rolled out after the SN5 prototype had hopped. So, on Sunday, SpaceX began the process of preparing for testing this SN6 tank. Throughout most of the road closure window on Sunday, the company had the road closed and tried their first attempt early. However, they had to abort the test multiple times to presumably fix issues that came up. Then, some hour or so before the end of the road closure window, they started fueling and SN6 was seen venting once again. Finally, just before the end of the window, the SN6 prototype and Raptor engine SN29 roared to life for the first time. This is the first step in paving way for the upcoming 150 meter hop test coming this week. After the static fire, we waited as the dust cleared to present a still standing SN6 prototype indicating a successful test. Even though I showed them last episode, here are the road and beach closures again. You can see that SpaceX is still targeting Friday 28 for the SN6 150 meter hop. Really excited, we could see a Falcon 9 and Starship launch on Friday, as well as another Falcon 9 launch on Saturday. So with the static fire test done and the hop coming up very soon, engineers have been working to prepare the pad and vehicle. Looks like they are doing some work with the ground support equipment here. Then, like we've seen with multiple previous Starship test tanks, the mass simulator was spotted having arrived on a trailer. So, looks like SN6, just like its predecessors, will also get a little hat. This block of steel will simulate the weight of the nose cone, upper rings and header tanks. I believe it weighs around 22 tons. They are currently still preparing for the installation of this mass simulator, but meanwhile tankers have been spotted doing the usual refueling at the tank farm. Anyhow, moving on to the future Starship prototypes, here we have the upper ring stack for SN9. It was seen sitting outside waiting to be sleeved with the upper bulkhead for the methane tank. That's the next thing to also happen, the ring stack and dome were sleeved with one another. This ring stack has a lot of those TPS tile mounting points, so SN9 looks like it will have many heat shield tiles. With various sections as well as canards spotted, here is the latest SN9 build diagram from Brendan Lewis. With SN5 out of the mid bay and SN9 action picking up, we could soon start to see the SN9 tank begin being born. As always, these detailed and regular updates would not be possible without the time and dedication from Mary or Boca Chica girl going out there and filming, so thank you. Also, thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team for all their work and effort behind the scenes, especially when they spend hours hosting the testing live streams. We thank you all greatly. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.